Do I have to say I'm Madonna? Ugh, I hate saying that.
What do you want to say?
Hi. I mean, if I'm them, don't you think they'll know who I am by then?
Madonna y su bla bla bla. En esta segunda parte, otra entrevista de 1984, el año de su gran despegue. Mientras el tema Lucky Star se ponía de moda, la cara de Madonna fue una de las que se vieron en el New Music Seminar, un encuentro de músicos que se realizó aquí, en el New York Hilton, y donde también participaron como panelistas gente ya reconocida en ese entonces como George Clinton, África Bambaata, Fred Schneider de B-52, John Oates, Lou Reed y el mismísimo James Brown.
Well, it was a real thrill to be sitting with some artists who I really respect and admire, James Brown, George Clinton, so on and so forth. And in addition to that, I felt like I had something to share with a lot of other people who are aspiring recording artists if they had any questions about what, you know, what they could look forward to or any advice I could give them, you know, before, you know, on getting a record contract. So I think I had a valid contribution to make.
Videos might have a limited audience in one sense, but on the other hand, you could be reaching a lot of people that would never be able to come and see you live. So I think that they're definitely an advantage.
I think
and
make
kids
it
only. I'm sorry, but you know, kids today worship the television. So I think it's a great way to reach them.
I sort of resent the fact that a kid grows up, you know, listening to the radio and listening to the great music, you know, legacy of music that we have, and dreams about playing the guitar or playing the drums, and all of a sudden has to be an actor. To me, that makes absolutely no sense at all. If someone wants to be, that's great, but as far as I'm concerned, you know, I always wanted to be a musician, and, you know, to me, that's still my purpose.
Yeah, but listen, when you perform on stage, you're acting. I mean, that's a performance, so what's... I mean, if someone puts a camera on you, what's the difference? You're acting right now.
My definition of new music is something that's, you know, fresh and reflecting of, you know, the times, the politics, the fashion, the energy, something new. You know, something that's applicable to what's happening in the world today.
How do you think your music fits into?
Well, to start off with, a lot of people thought that I was a black artist before they saw my videos because a lot of my music is more R&B oriented, and I think that I'm a white artist doing R&B music, getting played on pop stations, and I think that that is the kind of records I make is really changing people's ideas of, you know, splitting up, you know, categorizing music, and I think that's opening up ways for black and white artists as well. So that's something new. I just finished recording an album with Nile Rodgers, and I helped put it out in October, but they're still playing stuff off my last album, which I can't complain, but I'm really anxious to get the new stuff out. So you can expect a new release in October.
You start working on the videos?
Yes, I have a video that's already ready for the new single I'm putting out in October. There's a video which I shot in Venice a couple of weeks ago, and I'm really excited about that too.
Can you give us some more details? Who directed it?
Mary Lambert directed it. She directed my Borderline video, and you know, I worked with her again because I thought she was really great.
What's the title?
Like a Virgin.
Anything else?
No comment from the Peanut Gallery. I'm gonna do another video for the release, the second release after Like a Virgin. And so I'm thinking about that. I'm also getting together a tour. I plan to go on tour upon the release of my album in October, an American tour of major cities, and possible parts in movies, but I can't really talk about that, so.
As far as your band for the tour?
Yeah, who am I going to use on the band? A lot of different people, some people that I've been working with through the years. I mean, I had a band before I got a record contract, so some of those musicians, and I'm still not finished auditioning people. So I'm not even sure myself. But whoever they are, they're going to be great.
A pesar de todos sus planes, los fans de Madonna debieron esperar más de un año hasta que finalmente pudo salir de gira. Eso sí, como anticipo, tuvieron su primera aparición en la primera edición de los MTV Video Music Awards, que se realizó en el teatro que está a mis espaldas, el Radio City.